in your hands. He has placed all mankind in the beast of the field and the birds in the sky. Wherever, wherever, wherever they live, he has made you ruler over them, over them. You are that head of gold. After you, another kingdom will arise, inferior to yours. Next, a third kingdom, one of bronze, will rule over the whole earth. Finally, there will be a fourth kingdom, strong as iron. For iron breaks and smashes everything, and as iron breaks things to pieces, so it will crush and break all the others. Just as you saw that the feet and toes were partly in baked clay and partly of iron, so this will be a divided kingdom, yet it will have some of the strength of iron in it. Even as you saw iron mixed with clay, as the toes were partly iron and partly clay, so this kingdom will be partly strong and partly brittle. And just as you saw the iron mixed with baked clay, so the people will be a mixture and will not remain ununited anymore. Then iron mixes with clay. In the time of those kings, the God Yahweh of heaven will set up a kingdom that will never be destroyed, nor will it be left to another people. It will crush all those kingdoms and bring them to an end, but it will itself endure forever and ever and ever. This is the meaning of the vision of the rock cut out of a mountain, but not by human hands. A rock that broke the iron, the bronze, the clay, the silver, and the gold to pieces. The great Yahweh has shown the king the world will take place in the future. The dream is true and its interpretation is trustworthy. Yeah. Then King Nebuchadnezzar fell prostrated before the Daniel the Belshazzar and paid him honor, in order that an offering and incense be prepared.